Hello everyone. Welcome to our YouTube channel. Number 1 Doctor. Today we'll continue to discuss the complications of bariatric surgery. Today we will discuss the complication of gastric band. Welcome Doctor.
Thanks for you and for all watchers.
Doctor. Gastric band is a purely restrictive procedure that involves placement of an adjustable silicone device at the gastric cardia near the gastroesophageal junction, limiting the amount of food consumed. Restriction can be adjusted by injecting saline into a subcutaneous port connected to the band. Gastric band is the second most common weight loss surgery performed in the United States. From 2010 to 2014, there has been an increase of 329% in the number of gastric band procedures. Gastric band has the lowest mortality rate among all bariatric procedures. The Australian Safety and Efficacy Register of New Interventional Procedures reported 3 deaths out of 5,827 gastric banding procedures, 0.05%.
Gastric band has been associated with several complications. An initial trial of gastric band in the United States showed disappointing weight loss outcomes and high complication rates, associated with relatively high revisional surgery rate, 40%. Following changes in the surgical technique, subsequent trials in Europe, Australia, and the United States have shown fewer complications. Long-term results from a series of 78 gastric band patients showed that nearly 40% of patients experienced major complications, 22% had minor complications, and almost half of the patients required reoperation. Major complications included pouch dilation, 11%, band erosion, 28%, and band infection, 1%. Minor complications included incisional hernias, 5%, port tubing disconnections, 20%, and port infections, 2%. Complications of gastric band can occur early or late. Early complications include acute stomal obstruction, band infection, gastric perforation, hemorrhage, bronchopneumonia, and delayed gastric emptying and pulmonary embolism. Pulmonary embolism was the most common cause of early mortality in a series of 9,682 gastric band patients. Late complications include band erosion, band slippage or prolapse, port or tubing malfunction, leakage at the port site tubing or band, pouch or esophageal dilatation and esophagitis. Almost 50% of patients will need surgical revision or removal of the band. Failed bands, due either to complications or inadequate weight loss, can generally be converted to other bariatric procedures such as Roux-en-Y gastric bypass surgery or a duodenal switch. In addition, the rate of long-term complications and rates of reoperation are higher with LAP gastric band compared with bypass surgery. In a prospective study of 442 patients matched for age, gender, and BMI, patients undergoing gastric band had a significantly higher rate of long-term complications compared with patients undergoing bypass surgery. Patients undergoing gastric band also had a higher rate of reoperation at 6 years of follow-up, 26.7 versus 12.7%.
Doctor, what about stomal obstruction as a complication of gastric band?
Acute stomal obstruction is an early complication that can occur in up to 14% of gastric band patients. Obstruction is usually caused by inclusion of excess perigastric fat, use of a band of insufficient diameter for the thickness of the tissue or significant tissue edema. Patients usually present with persistent nausea, vomiting, and inability to tolerate secretions or oral intake. The diagnosis is confirmed with an upper gastrointestinal series demonstrating no passage of contrast beyond the band. Acute stomal obstruction due to edema can initially be treated conservatively with nasogastric tube decompression until the edema subsides, although a potential for aspiration pneumonia and stomach ischemia exists. Persistent obstruction requires surgical revision or removal of the band. Meticulous removal of excess perigastric fat at the time of initial band placement may help prevent this complication. The use of larger diameter bands may also help to reduce the incidence of acute postoperative obstruction.
Doctor, what about port infection as a complication of gastric band?
Port infection has been reported in 0.3 to 9% of gastric band patients. Because the port is a foreign body, port infection is treated with surgical removal, especially in association with band erosion. Overall, the incidence of port site infection ranges from 0.3 to 9%. Band erosion is first ruled out via upper endoscopy since post-infections may be one of the first signs indicating the presence of an erosion. If an isolated port infection is found, the infected port is removed and a new port is reimplanted once the infection clears.
Doctor, what about band erosion as a complication of gastric band?
Band erosion through the wall of the stomach has been reported in up to 7% of gastric band patients, and it is thought to occur as a result of either gastric wall ischemia from an excessively tight band, mechanical trauma related to the band buckle, or thermal trauma from electrosurgical energy sources used during band placement. Band erosion is a late complication and occurs at a mean of 22 months after surgery. Introduction of new band technology and placement technique is likely to result in a reduction of band erosions, as reported by more recent studies. Clinical signs of band erosion include infection, failure of weight loss, or nausea and vomiting. Epigastric pain and hematemesis can also signal erosion of the lap band into the left gastric artery. This can happen when the lap band erodes into the posterior part of the stomach near the cardioesophageal junction. This complication can be avoided by careful placement during the initial surgery, making sure not to include the ascending branch of the left gastric artery during band placement. Band erosion can be diagnosed by endoscopy and treatment involves removal of the band, which can be done laparoscopically. Successful endoscopic removal has also been reported when the buckle of the band is visible endoscopically. It is generally recommended that revision to another bariatric procedure be delayed for at least 2 to 3 months after an episode of band erosion, as the complication rate with immediate revision is increased.
Doctor, what about band slippage and gastric prolapse as a complication of gastric band?
Band slippage involves prolapse of part of the stomach through the band, with varying degrees of gastric obstruction. Anterior prolapse involves migration of the band cephalad, which creates an acute angle with the stomach pouch and esophagus, resulting in obstruction. Posterior gastric prolapse occurs when the stomach migrates cephalad, displacing the band caudally and creating a new pouch. Slippage rates were as high as 24% in the initial FDA trial, but more recent series show a much lower incidence of 2 to 14%. An early technique involving paragastric dissection with placement of a lap band directly on the stomach wall was associated with frequent gastric prolapse. A newer technique via pars flaccida without exposure of the stomach wall has decreased this complication significantly. Gastric prolapse is characterized by food intolerance, epigastric pain, and acid reflux. Diagnosis is confirmed with an upper gastrointestinal series demonstrating either malposition of the band or dilatation and prolapse of the gastric pouch. Surgery is required urgently or emergently. Depending on the presentation, repair of the prolapse can sometimes be accomplished by repositioning the band, but often the band needs to be replaced or removed altogether, especially if significant inflammation is found.
Doctor, what about port malfunction as a complication of gastric band?
Port malfunction results if the tubing disconnects, subcutaneous port flips, or leakage within the system occurs. Such problems lead to inability to titrate the instilled volume of saline in the system. Reported incidence of port and tubing malfunction ranges from 0.4 to 7.0%. These problems usually become evident as an inability to access port and maintain band volume, or the development of weight gain. These complications require surgical repair or exchange of the hardware to attain band adjustability. Port dislocation can be reduced by attaching the port to a broad surface mesh first before anchoring to the rectus fossa.
Doctor, what about esophagitis as a complication of gastric band?
Esophagitis and reflux are infrequent complications following lap band. Deflation of the band and acid suppression therapy are the mainstays of treatment. However, if intractable to medical therapy, band removal or conversion to other procedures such as gastric bypass surgery may be necessary.
Doctor, what about esophageal dilatation as a complication of gastric band?
Esophageal dilatation proximal to the band device has been observed in as many as 10% of patients. This so-called pseudo-achalasia syndrome may develop when the band is excessively inflated or in the setting of excessive amounts of food intake. Pouch dilatation has also been associated with a history of binge eating behavior. Patients often present with food and saliva intolerance, reflux, and epigastric discomfort. The diagnosis can be confirmed with an upper gastrointestinal series. The initial treatment should be removal of all the fluid from the band and behavioral diet modifications. This is usually successful in reversing esophageal dilatation. However, persistent dilatation may require replacement of the band in a new location on the stomach or conversion to a different procedure. Deflation of the band alone is usually successful in reversing esophageal dilatation. However, persistent dilatation may require replacement of the band to a new location on the stomach or conversion to a different procedure.
Doctor, what about hiatus hernia as a complication of gastric band?
Hiatus hernia is often a pre-existing but unrecognized condition in patients undergoing bariatric surgery. This can lead to ongoing intractable reflux necessitating reoperation or band removal. Thus, a simple crural repair can be performed at the initial operation to avoid these complications. A retrospective review of 1298 patients who underwent gastric band alone and 520 patients who underwent gastric band with concurrent hiatal hernia repair showed that the rate of reoperation was significantly reduced in patients who had hiatal repair at the time of gastric band as compared with those who had gastric band alone, 1.7 versus 5.6%, respectively.
Thanks, doctor, for these excellent information. Thanks for watching our video. Hope to see you in next videos. Please do not forget to like and share our video. Watch other videos in our channel. Join our YouTube channel number 1 Doctor. Follow us on social media accounts in the links in the description below the video. And visit our website, dratef.net. With my best wishes, Dr. Atef Ahmed.